Today we're going to install Prometheus stack on Kubernetes. It includes Prometheus Operator, Prometheus Alert Manager, Grafana, Default Service Monitors, Dashboards, and Alerts. Then we will deploy the Postgres database in its own namespace, and I'll show you how to manually describe the metrics endpoint and configure the service monitor. If you would like to deploy a Prometheus stack using plain YAML, I have another video explaining all the details. Alright, let's get started. For this tutorial, I will create a brand new EKS cluster using EKSETL. This is a cluster config where we can define the Kubernetes version, instance groups, and other parameters for the cluster. Let's go to the terminal and apply the config. To customize the Prometheus Helm chart, we need to override the default values. Let's create a Prometheus values.yaml file and provide our variables. Since we are using EKS, which is a managed Kubernetes cluster, the control plane is abstracted from us and we don't need to manage or monitor etcd, scheduler or controller. First, let's disable Prometheus alerts for etcd and a kube scheduler, then disable service monitors for them. Also, let's add a custom label Prometheus equal to DevOps. This label will be used by Prometheus operator to select service monitor objects. The last thing, we need to update common labels and add the same Prometheus equal to DevOps label. If you won't add it, the Prometheus operator will ignore default service monitors created by this Helm chart, and your Prometheus target section will be empty. Optionally, you can update the Grafana admin password. Before we can install Prometheus Helm chart, we need to add a Prometheus community repo. Let's search for the kube Prometheus stack Helm chart. I highly suggest starting with the same Helm chart version, and when you manage to deploy it successfully, then you can upgrade to the latest version. To install, let's specify release name, Helm chart name, variables that we want to rewrite, version of the chart, namespace where we want to deploy, and create namespace flag in case you don't have the monitoring namespace yet. Now let's get all the pods and services in the monitoring namespace. Next, we're going to port forward the Prometheus service to localhost and access it locally on port 9090. Let's open Chrome and navigate to localhost. Under the target section, you can see all the default targets provided by this Helm chart. Unfortunately, EKS configures kubeproxy metrics to only be accessible on the localhost for those pods. We can review and update this parameter in the config map. Let's use the seed command to replace 127.0.0.1 with 0.0.0.0 to access metrics externally. When we update config map, it will not restart the pods, we need to do it manually. There are a couple of options, either to use kubectl rollout restart command or directly patch the daemon set, which will trigger a restart. Now, if you go back to Prometheus UI and refresh the browser, all the targets should be up. This Helm chart also provides default Prometheus alerts and Grafana dashboards. To access Grafana locally, we need to port forward Grafana service as well. Now let's go to localhost 3000 and enter our credentials, admin for the username and test123 for the password. Let's open few dashboards provided by the kube Prometheus stack Helm chart. For the second part, let's deploy the Postgres Helm chart in the DB namespace and configure the service monitor manually. First of all, we need to add a Bitnami chart repository. For this demo, we're going to be using the first Bitnami Postgres SQL chart with the version 10.5.0. Let's go to the official Helm chart GitHub repo to take a look at the default values which we can override. let's create a Postgres values file with our variables. First, let's give a name test for our database. Then enable Metrics to deploy Prometheus exporter as a sidecar. We can create a service monitor using this chart by setting enable to true. However, I want to show you how to create it manually. Now let's deploy this Helm chart to the DB namespace. We can run kubectl get pods to verify the deployment. Now let's create a service monitor object to monitor the Postgres database. On the line 9, we need to add the same label that Prometheus operator expects. To verify that you actually need to use Prometheus equal to DevOps label, you can use kubectl get Prometheus command and compare it with the service monitor selector. To fill up the rest of the fields, let's get endpoints in the DB namespace. Postgres SQL endpoint is created automatically by the service. Now, to get all the parameters, describe the metrics endpoint. First is the port name, which is HTTP metrics. Then we need to explicitly specify namespace DB. Last is a selector. Here you need to select the endpoint using labels. To add the Postgres database to the Prometheus, simply apply this object. Prometheus operator will take the content of it and update the config map of Prometheus and trigger hot reload. Let's go to the Prometheus target section and reload the page. It will take a few seconds to reload the config and Prometheus will start scraping the targets. Also, if you want to know what parameters are available when you configure the service monitor, you can go to Prometheus operator GitHub repository. Under documentation and API, search for service monitor spec and select the endpoint object. Here are the options that you can use in your service monitor config. Now let's import the Grafana dashboard for the Postgres. Let's search for 9628 ID in the search box. Then go to the Grafana and click Import, enter Postgres dashboard ID and click Load. Alright, this is open source Postgres dashboard for Prometheus exporter that is used in the Helm chart. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.